Well, hello for you, and welcome to Trig Ratios and Special Angles. Our goal today, I remember what the special angles are and can adapt them to work with radian measure. Okay, so trig ratios and special angles. First thing I'm going to do is show you how to type it into your calculator. And the calculator I'm going to pull up here works backwards. Oops, let's clear that. So what I'm going to do is type in this part first and then hit sign. If your calculator works frontwards, you can probably type it in exactly the way it looks because your calculator is just a little bit simpler that way. First thing you have to do is make sure that it is in radians. Now I've got this in radians. I had to toggle this little button here. Degree, radians, degree, radians, degree, radians. So you need to look on your calculator. And if you don't know how to switch back and forth between radians and degrees, you need to have a little chat with me about your calculator. So now that I've got it in radians, I'm going to just type in 2 pi by 3. So I go 2 times pi divided by 3 equals. Now that gives me 2 pi by 3. And now I have to hit sign. So I get 0.866. 0.866. Now, if I want cosecant, remember cosecant is just the reciprocal of sine, all I have to do is flip this over. This is 0.866 over 1. I need to do 1 over 0.866. So this button will actually do it. It goes 1 over whatever's on the screen. You may have a button that looks like x to the negative 1, or you may have one that looks like 1 over x. Either way, you're going to hit it, and we get 1.155. So 1.155. Now you can do that with the rest of them too. Type them in. I'm not going to do that. Cosecant, you're going to get negative 0.5. And when you flip over a half, you get 2. And it's still going to be negative. And for tan, you actually get negative 1.732 or negative 0.577 for the cotangent when you flip it over. Okay, now moving right along, 2/3 pi, or 2 pi by 3, is actually a multiple of a special angle. And if we have the multiple of the special angle, we can get an exact answer using special triangles, the unit circle, and the cast rule. So I'm going to pull this down and remind us of what our special triangles were. Now remember, our special triangles, the first one we had, had two sides the same length. And of course, if two sides were the same length, then these two angles in here were of the same degree, and it just happened to be, since this is 90, that those two have to be 45. Now, don't write this down, because I'm going to put the actual radian measure in there in a minute. To get to 45, what do I have to divide 180 by to get to 45 degrees? Well, the answer to that is 4. 180 divided by 4 is 45. So what this actually is, remember 180 degrees is pi, so this is pi by 4. And then this down here we refer to as pi by 4 as well, because it's also 45. Now 90 degrees is 180 divided by 2, so 90 degrees is pi by 2. But we don't have to put pi by 2 in there. It's still just 90 degrees. Now, when we're using the special triangles, we said, let's take the smallest one, the one that has these two sides equal to 1. And then by Pythagorean theorem, we can do 1 squared plus 1 squared is 2, and then take the square root is square root 2. So there's our first special triangle. Our second special triangle had 60 in the big angle, 30 in the small angle, because 60 and 30 add to 90. And the side lengths were 1, 2, root 3. And we know that 2 is the hypotenuse, and root 3 is bigger than 1, so it has to go across from the bigger angle. And of course, 1 goes across from the smaller angle. Now, I hope you didn't write the 60 and 30 in there, because we're going to put those in terms of radian measure as well. We know that to get 60, I have to divide 180 by 3. So this is pi by 3. And to get 30, I have to divide 180 by 6. So this is pi by 6. Now, remember the cast rule told us where, because of the unit circle, it told us where things were positive, which trig ratio was positive in which quadrant. I'm not going to go into the unit circle or cast rule. You learned those things last year. We're going to use the same principles. And cast rule tells us that cos down here is positive. Up here, all of the trig ratios are positive. Over here, sine is positive, and down here, tan is positive. So remember, that is cos is positive here, all are positive here, sine and tan. So we're going to find the six exact ratios for 2 pi by 3. First thing we have to figure out is, where is 2 pi by 3? Is it in quad 1? Is it in quad 2? Is it in quad 3? Or is it in quad 4? Well, 2 pi by 3 is actually a little more than half. If I wanted half, if I split something into 3 and I wanted half, I would have to have 1.5 pi by 3, which isn't a good way to write it. You should never put a decimal inside a fraction. However, that gives us an idea of where 2 pi by 3 is. It's over in this quadrant over here. So I'm going to draw that on right over here. Now, that means this is 2 pi by 3. And remember, we start at 0 and we rotate this way. So this one is 90 degrees, or pi by 2. We rotate this. This is 180 degrees, or pi. Another 90 degrees means that this is 3 pi by 2. And then another 90 degrees, we're back at 2 pi. And we can keep going and going and going and going if we want to, but we don't, so we won't. So we're going to go 2 pi by 3 is right here. Now remember that I'm going to have a similar angle in every side. That if this is the unit circle, the coordinates of this point right here are, and I'm going to remove these numbers here, the coordinates of that point there are cos of 2 pi by 3 and sine of 2 pi by 3. And if we're using the unit circle, that means that over here I have another angle here, and it's going to have the same sine and the same cos, just with different signs, because this point here, if we're looking at the unit circle, it's the same distance away from the y, so its x is going to be positive where mine is negative, and its y is going to be exactly the same because it's exactly the same distance above. And it just so happens that that point over there would be pi by 3. So it is acceptable for me to use this triangle in here where this here is pi by 3. So if I can just use pi by 3 here and figure out what my sine, cos, and tan of pi by 3 is, it's going to be exactly the same as 2 pi by 3, except with different signs. And to cover the different signs, I use cast rule. So what does this mean? Well, it means that 2 pi by 3 and pi by 3 have the same values of all of these trig ratios, just with different signs. So I'm going to use pi by 3 for my special angle. So the sine of pi by 3 is opposite over hypotenuse, so it's root 3 over 2. The cos is adjacent over hypotenuse, so it's a half. And the tan is opposite over adjacent, so it is root 3 over 1, or just simply root 3. Okay. Opposite over hypotenuse, adjacent over hypotenuse, opposite over adjacent. Now to get these, we just flip them over. So I've got 2 over root 3. 2 over 1, which is just 2, and 1 over root 3. Now, how about sines? Well, if we go by cast rule, C-A-S-T, it tells me that sine is positive in here, and everything else is negative. So we leave the sine positive, cos is negative, tan is negative, and when you flip over negatives, you get negatives, so those are negatives. Now, how does that compare? Because we already found this with the calculator. If we look up here, we had negatives here, and let's take a look at the easiest one. We've got negative a half and negative 2, and down here we have negative a half and negative 2. Now generally for the reciprocals, we don't leave a radical in the denominator, so we have to rationalize the denominator, so we would multiply top and bottom by root 3. And so for this to be perfectly acceptable form, it's going to be 2 root 3 over 3. So that equals 2 root 3 over 3. And down here, we would multiply top and bottom by root 3. So that would give me negative root 3 over 3. Okay, let's try a couple more. We'll go over here. Find the 6 trig ratios for 7 pi by 6. Well, where on earth is 7 pi by 6? Well, this is bigger than 1 whole pi, because 1 whole pi would be 6 pi by 6. So 1 whole pi would take me down over to this side, because remember this is 0, pi by 2, and then pi, and then 3 pi by 2. Well, 7 pi by 6, 6 pi by 6 would take me to here, and then I need to go 1 more pi by 6 over into this quadrant to get my triangle. So this is 7 pi by 6 all the way around, but this little angle in here is just plain old pi by 6. Because I've got 6 pi by 6 to get me to here, and then another pi by 6 to give me 7 pi by 6s. So I'm going to use this little triangle in here that's pi by 6. Now I'm going to flip back to my special triangle, because I can still use pi by 6. I'm going to use pi by 6 because it's a multiple of 7 pi by 6. So if I use pi by 6, sine is opposite over hypotenuse, so sine is a half. Cos is adjacent over hypotenuse, so root 3 over 2. And tan is opposite over adjacent, so opposite over adjacent, 1 over root 3. Now we have to remember the cast rule to get our signs right, C, A, S, T. So down here, only tan is positive, so the other two are negative. And then, of course, for the reciprocal functions, we can just flip them over. So that's going to be negative 2, negative 2 over root 3. And then flipping that over, we get root 3. And, of course, for these two things, you should probably rationalize the denominator, but I'm not going to do that right now. Okay. Next, for the quadrant boundaries, pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, and 2 pi, and its multiples, we must think of a unit circle. Remember that the x coordinate is cosine, and the y coordinate is sine, and also remember the quotient identity, tan equals sine over cos. So all of those are special angles, and we remembered the unit circle, so let's look at the coordinates of each of these things. So right here, the coordinate of this is 1, 0. And remember, since this is on the unit circle, this is the cos of 0. And the sine of 0. Hence, cos 0 must equal 1, and sine 0 must equal 0. That is also true because this point not only represents 0, but it also represents 2 pi. Because once we've gone around one whole rotation, we're at 2 pi. Put those back. So we have cos of 2 pi equals 1 and sine of 2 pi equals 0. Now, how about for pi by 2? Up here, since this rotation in here is now pi by 2, the coordinates here are going to be cos pi by 2, sine pi by 2, using the unit circle. However, we also happen to know that since this is on the unit circle, this is 1 unit up and 0 units over. So this is 0 and 1 is what this point is using the unit circle. So that means that the cos of pi by 2 equals 0 And the sine of pi by 2 equals 1. Going over to this one here, this is straight up pi. I've got a rotation of pi. Let's go around. Pi. And the coordinates of this point are negative 1, comma 0, if we're using the unit circle. And so this is going to be cos pi and sine pi. So we can say cos pi equals negative 1 and sine pi equals 0. One last one down here. This one is going to be the cos of 3 pi by 2, sine of 3 pi by 2. And if we're going by the unit circle, the actual points here is 0 left and right. So this first coordinate is 0. And up and down, it's going to be negative 1. So that tells me that the cos of 3 pi by 2 equals 0. And the sine of 3 pi by 2 equals negative 1. And so you have to think of the unit circle here if you're looking at for all of those different ones. Okay, we got one more example. Find the exact answer in simplest radical form. So I need the sine of pi by 6. Well, where's my special triangle? The sine of pi by 6, here's pi by 6, sine is opposite over hypotenuse, so that's 1/2. If you memorize these, this will go quicker, but so the sine of pi by 6 is 1/2. And we are going to add to that the cos of pi by 4. So going back to my special triangle, the cos of pi by 4 is adjacent over hypotenuse, so it's 1 over root 2. So we're going to add to that plus 1 over root 2. Now it says do it in simplest radical form, so I need to actually get a common denominator and add these things together. So my common denominator is going to be 2 root 2. This had a 2, it needs a root 2, so I have to multiply top and bottom there by root 2. This thing has a root 2, it needs a 2, so I have to multiply top and bottom there by 2. So what I end up getting in my numerator is root 2 plus 2. And now I should rationalize the denominator, so I'm going to multiply top and bottom by root 2. And if I multiply top and bottom by root 2, here's what I get. Remember, this has to multiply backwards that way. So on the bottom, I'm going to get root 2 times root 2 is just 2, and 2 times 2 is 4. So on the bottom, I have 4. And then root 2 times root 2 is just 2 plus 2 root 2. Root 2 times root 2 is 2, and then plus 2 times root 2. And so this is in simplest radical form. Well, actually, it's not quite in simplest radical form, because I can factor something out of the numerator. I can take a 2 out of the numerator. And if I take a 2 out of the numerator, I get 1 plus root 2 over 4. The 2 cancels into the 4 twice. So my actual answer is 1 plus root 2 over 2. So this requires remembering how to do some of your work with radicals. And that concludes this lesson for today.